Alright, well, this is gonna be a little change from the last video, but I don't know. This is difficult. I've made this fulfillment center, you know, with the database linkage. This is very difficult to make one of these online stores. I'm really surprised by the process. I'm not happy with it, but that's the way it goes. So you have to be an Excel programmer. or you have to like just enter it in one at a time, and I don't think a human being can actually do that normally and keep track of it all. So you really have to be an Excel database programmer, or you have to use like their fulfillment centers, and so they get you get chump changed on everything. So yeah. So when everybody says let's go sell it online or whatever, it's not so easy. It's not so easy at all. It's not something that you'd be taken light of. Because I mean, just inventory itself, gaining it, putting it into this machine, and most things are not ISBN or whatever. They're just not. A lot of them are older or whatever, and so they require extra searches. So no, it's not the party everybody wanted. It's not great. Selling online is not great. It has mandatory hours when you have to ship it out by, and it's not fabulous. And they take the post office boxes away and lower their... They used to pick up at 6:30 in the morning, and now all of a sudden the post department has gone sleepy and they won't even wake up at 6:30 and pick up at a box. I mean, this type of thing is going on. You know, so let's say you had packages that you were just going to drop in the box in the night, easy, and they go in the morning, before 12. But no, they have taken those away. So I'm just like, what's the deal? This is supposed to be a major metropolis, and the post office is lazy, and they can't actually get their act together to put a little car out there and pick up at 6:30. And I'm talking, just boxes after boxes after boxes. None of them have 6:30 anymore. So it's kind of a drama. So they're pushing it out to way later. So they're making I don't know. It's a difficult process. This whole thing, and then you have to be doing bidding rules of you know their guidelines whatever. So I'm trying to stick to their guidelines and trying to be you know this that and the other, while I'm dealing with yes this is my inventory. You know, full scale, this is my inventory, and it has been for an entire year. I've been here in practically inhaling book dust, and I need some kind of accolation of respect for that, at least. Yes, she's running her little bookstore, all right? So give her you know, that type of an obvious, because this is dang difficult. This is dang difficult. I have to make photos of each one of these things, and then I'm like, well, great. So each one of you are now like, oh, grabby. I don't need family members to get grabby over these items ever. Not for one minute. Not off the work of my back. Not off the work of my eyes. Not off the work of my brain. Do you understand? Not one of you have the right to do that. So, I imagine this is going on in lots of families out there. You know, all of a sudden you have the brain child who can do it, and you all want something out of that brain child. Well, you're not going to get it out of me. Do you understand? You're not. You're not going to be thefts to me. You're not stealing from me. You know, I'm already dealing with a very bad situation. You know, my father believes that I'm going to be able to fund his retirement off this little bookshop. Do you understand how bad it is? You know, he thinks I can run his entire, I can pay for his entire retirement now off of this little bookshop. Off of the little books that my mother collected, or I collected through my lifetime. And the few that he has collected, and yes, they're much older, and they're not easy. They're not easy to sell. So yeah, I have to deal with this, that type of delusion in this expensive Bay Area. So it's not a good day. It's not a good day. And I have to deal with the fact that what? What is the deal? Why do I have the feeling that I have 1,000 men who just want me dead? That goes on. You know, I have to go back to my husband and wonder, what? What was his extravagant want me dead for? I have to go back to my father here? What is his extravagant want me dead for? I mean, in essence, all the time, no, it's mine, no, it's mine, the greed machine. These types of people want you dead. I mean, if they're so greedy, they were never going to do it. They were never going to make money off any of these things. And yet, in preference, they prefer you just out with nothing. Dead. Do you understand? So yeah, I'm like, well, great. And so my father is the one. Oh, here I'm blabbing today. I know it. My father is the one who's given money to my husband. And so when the token gesture of a few old gross books come my way, the extravagance of greed rears its head up and says it's mine after all of my work. This is the drama. How come it's fair? How come it's fair for a man to give money to another man? But how come he does not want to give to a daughter? What is going on with that? And then I'm going to look back, well, maybe it's all of his children. Maybe he just doesn't want to give to his children. So I'm just dealing with a case of absolute insanity. So here goes, you know, I'm sent into tears this morning. I'm sent into tears. Because I'm supposed to fund his retirement now off the selling of this stupid book here. Do you understand? I'm supposed to fund his retirement. I really need you all to wake up and understand the severity of this situation. I asked for power of attorney over my father. Nobody has helped me. I walked into the lawyers. I asked for power of attorney with my father. The lawyer put me out into the hallway and sent me astray and said no. This has got to stop. If anything, if I have rights as a human being, that lawyer can be sued. Because he has put me under severe stress over this situation. Severe duress. This is impossible. I am dealing with an impossible situation. And I expect and I demand at this point some kind of respect of my duration of presence. 1 year I have been here. I expect some kind of respect of my duration of presence. Do you understand what that means? Companionship. His personal escort. I demand the power of attorney. in a case where not one of these items were going to be saved, not one of these items were going to be salvaged, in that case, I demand respect over this situation. And so that lawyer, that little whatever, I don't know, he deserves to be sued because he has put me under duress. He has not let me have the onus rights normal. And those onus rights normal are absolutely that compendium statement that yes, Teresa is here and she is absolutely the one in charge of the situation and of this old father. So I really need somebody, some goddamn buddy to help me. So any hoot. Yeah. So you're all listening to the bitings of an old man? The bitings of an old man. Anyway. Yeah. Talk about ruining my life. Talk about ruining my life. How dare you? How dare that lawyer for absolutely imbibing stress in my direction? Something I just needed absolutely fixed. How dare he be the swayer in the other direction and let the old man just go off? Just go off and think that whatever he can do, whatever he wants to do. Meanwhile, in his mind, we're going to live his retirement off the selling of this book. So in the consumption, how am I able to do anything normal? I mean, he's consumed my life. Do you understand? Consumed it. I've requested an out. I want out of here. I want out of this Bay Area. I want cheaper rent for myself and my father. I've requested this again and again and again. My father is like not even able to handle the concept. My brothers ignore me. The lawyer won't give me power of attorney. What is going on? What sickness? What sickness is provided in your male minds? What sickness? What is this? What is this? Like, whatever. Whatever. Who is she? Who cares? What is this? Why are you all trying to kill me? Do you understand what duress does? Do you understand? Absolutely unconscionable. It's unconscionable behavior by all of these men. all of these men in my life. Do you understand? Unconscionable. I have never, ever deserved this. Never. Not for one day. Not this kind of treatment.